Welcome to the channel. Today, we're going to be taking a look at FalTac Unlimited holsters. I have two of them, and we're going to talk about them.
This review is completely off the cuff. I am not a firearms instructor. I am not an expert of Kydex. I am not a leather maker. I have no expertise in anything whatsoever. I am just a consumer who uses these products.
I think that if you're here watching this video, you probably know a thing or two about holsters. I'm just gonna tell you from a person who I have like 12 holsters from like seven different companies, my opinion on the FalTac Unlimited holster. Every firearm in this video is unloaded. So I had originally ordered this carbon fiber holster for the dagger, and this has a live-free armory slide on it. So it didn't really fit because I actually do have a Palmetto State Armory pistol that is completely PSA. Now, this one is interesting, right? Not bad. There's a lot of friction in this holster. And I don't really want to spend too much time on this one because I don't know. I think that with six different generations of slides and this being the fourth one, I believe, that, you know, I can't, again, how do I fault FalTac for anything? I know a lot of you at home are probably sitting there saying, adjust the tension, adjust the retention, adjust the screw, do this, do that. Well, like, that's something that's interesting about these holsters is they're kind of just put together to just work, right? And they work out of the box, they're fine. But once you start loosening that screw, you've just loosened the screw and it's not like the most precision adjustment where like I can take this screw on this Vetter holster and I can turn for days either way, you know, and I can figure it out. I can dial it in. What I ended up doing was ordering another holster. And I ordered one for my GX4. I got this one in zombie green because why not? Although I would not recommend such a bold color if you're trying to conceal carry and it doesn't blend in with your shorts or my skin is not zombie green colored. This one is probably the smoothest firearm inserting into the holster feeling of any holster that I've ever owned. I've owned quite a few. I've owned DeSantis, Works, VersaCarry. My go-to is Vetter. I'm not paying $120 for a holster. So for $70, got the zombie green, it's got the claw. I put the Ulti clip on there. Typically I would go with the 1.5 foamy or whatever you want to call it. So again, this might be my greatest holster, my best quality holster. It's just in there and it's just, but it comes right out. I can't even tell you how good this holster feels, okay? Compared to some other holsters that I have, this is my EDC. You can start laughing right away. I have just socks that I put insoles in and rubber band them to my holster. That's my wedge. Ew. All right, so I got my, this is a Vetter with my Glock 43X. I'm at a bad angle. Gets kind of complicated when you have a light on there. I like it. I have the same thing in a Works holster. Not bad, I don't mind it. This one was a little bit bulky, so I didn't go with it. This isn't like a really like a, hey, let's look at all these holsters and like look at the different companies. I just want, kind of want to show you, like, back to this, how defined the lines are Now keep in mind that Vetter is my go-to. I have like 5 holsters from them. It's just not as defined to me. The angles are a little bit rolling instead of like, and nobody really cares about my opinion. This P07, wow, amazing. This FalTac, better. Do you own a FalTac holster? Tell me what you think. If you have one, if you're looking to get one, or if you need a little bit of insight, you know, ask around. Everybody's an expert these days. Let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe if you want more content like this, because I don't really make many videos these days. So if you really want to know something, let me know. There's plenty of other stuff out there. So do some research. Thanks for watching. Have a good night.